push P. Yeah, push P, turn me up.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to my new video. Today we have three methods. One method, three measurements to see how good code is. Because most of it is opinion-based, but there's one measurement that's kind of more facts-based. So we have, what is it? So there's lines of code, source lines of code, cyclomatic complexity, and ABC. Those are the three measurements to compare code. And so right now, the one I'm studying is source lines of code. I was down here somewhere. The metric has the advantage of being easily garnered and reproduced, but suffers from many flaws. Using SLOC to predict the development effort needed for a new product is done by counting the SLOC of existing projects for which total effort is known. Deciding which of those existing projects the new project most resembles, and then running a cost estimation model to make the prediction. If the person doing the estimating is correct about which existing projects the new project most closely resembles, this prediction may be accurate. Measuring programmer productivity by counting lines of code assumes that all programmers write equally efficient code. However, novice programmers are often far more verbose than those with more experience. Yeah, that's kind of counter to what it was saying the other day. So basically, this same author, but it was another book. It was the book about Ruby. I don't know if I mentioned it in the video, but it's another. So this book right here is called 99 Bottles of Object-Oriented Programming. There's this other book that, like I said, from the same author, but it's called Object-Oriented Programming for Ruby. Similar topics, obviously object-oriented, that's like the goal. Organizing code. And it was saying something about how... Wait, what was I reading? So it's better to have longer code and reusable than shorter code. I think that's what it was saying. So right here, it's like, you know, by lines of code. Despite the fact that novices write more code to produce less function, by this metric, they can seem more productive. More code to produce less function. While the cost of maintenance is related to the size of an application, the way in which code is organized also matters, period. It is cheaper to maintain a well-designed application than it is to maintain a pile of spaghetti code. Bad code, pretty much. SLOC numbers reflect code volume, and while it's useful for some programmers, knowing SLOC alone is not enough to predict code quality. That's why they have three measurements. So now we have cyclo complexity. In 1976, Thomas J. McCabb, I think that's how you say it, published a complexity measure in which he asserted what is needed is a mathematical technique that will provide a quantitative basis for modularization and allow us to identify software modules that will be difficult to test or maintain. Alright, let's see. I didn't really get that, but let's look at the explanation down here. A mathematical technique to identify code that is difficult to test or maintain. This would be the perfect tool for assessing code in this paper. In his paper, McCabb described, this was, what, 1976? Damn. What? I know Fortran was a thing. Was that like, I wonder if that was by this era, 76. When you used to have the punch cards and stuff. It's a long time ago. You, like, laptops didn't exist. Like, you had to use, like, the computers they used. Wild. It's like a whole building. Alright. But yeah. Where was I? McCab describes his complexity, his cyclomatic complexity metric, an algorithm that counts the number of unique execution paths through a body of source code. Think of this algorithm as a little machine that ponders your code and then maps out all the possible routes through every combination of every branch of every conditional. A method with many deeply nested conditionals would score very high, while a method with no conditionals at all would score zero. So yeah, basically the higher you score, the better. Or, I don't even know what it wants you to score here. Cyclomatic complexity neither predicts application development time nor measures programmer productivity. Its desire to identify code that is difficult to test or maintain aims directly at code quality. Cyclomatic complexity can be used in several ways. First, you can use it in comparing code. If you have two variants of the same method, wait, hold on. Cyclomatic complexity can be used in several ways. First, you can use it to compare code. If you have two variants of the same method, you can choose between based on their cyclomatic complexity. Lower scores are better. So like the zero, right? And so the code with the lowest score is best. Next, you can use it to limit overall complexity. You can set standards for how high a score you're willing to accept, and require explicit dispensation before allowing code to exceed this maximum. Finally, you can use it to determine if you've written enough tests. Cyclomatic complexity tells you the minimum number of tests needed to cover all the logic in the code. So I'm assuming this is kind of like a multiplication type thing, where kind of like a map tree almost. Like a tree, yeah, like a tree diagram or something like that. You don't have complete test coverage. Cyclomatic complexity sounds great and it's easy to see that it could be useful. But if you use the world of code through a narrow lens. All right. Last one, you have assignments, branches, and conditions. Assignments, branches, the method. All right, so the problem with cyclomatic complexity is that it doesn't take everything into account. Code does more than just evaluate conditions. It also assigns values to variables and sends messages. These things add up. And as you do more and more of each, your code comes increasingly difficult to understand. In 1997, 21 years after the unveiling of cyclomatic complexity, Jerry Fitzpatrick published Applying the ABC Metric to C, C++, and Java, in which he describes a metric that does consider more than conditionals. His ABC stands for assignments. Yeah, he just said it, right? Assignments, branches, and conditions. where assignments is a count of variable assignments, all right? Branches counts not branches of an assignment, of a statement, as one could forgivably infer, but branches of control, meaning function calls or message sends. Conditions counts conditional logic. I guess it might be bad if there was like a lot of conditions. Nested ifs, while loops, stuff like that. A do while. Fitzpatrick describes the ABC metric as a measure of size, as if ABC is a more sophisticated version. It does seem like it, a more sophisticated version of SLOC. This is his metric, so he certainly gets to say what it represents. But you will not go wrong if you think of ABC scores as reflecting cognitive as opposed to physical size. High ABC numbers indicate code that takes up a lot of mental space in descent. ABC is a measure of complexity. High complex code is difficult to understand and change, therefore ABC scores are proxy for code quality. What does proxy mean? That does that mean that they're the best, or that it's the worst way to go about it? Alright, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and just copy this code, the inside code. Just this right here. And let's go ahead and look up, let's see, so first let's do SLOC. It's gonna have to be, so SLOC score for code. I mean, the lines of code, that would be like 40 something. Alright, let's look up the other one, which would be cyclomatic complexity. I'm wondering if there's like a way you can just copy and paste it on there. Also, an actual, you can't just paste it on there. Paste the code. Calculate. I did find this on the, it's a good website for, you know, for programming, but it doesn't look like there's a way to, I don't know, maybe I'm missing out on it. Alright, let's try the last one, see if it's on there or not. Alright, so what I'm looking for is something that you can paste. I mean, there's nothing on it. Yeah, there's nothing on it. There's a plugin, ABC plugin. They're all plugins. Yeah, so, okay. Yeah, that's not getting this anywhere. Apparently there's no, well, not that I know. There's no way to just paste it on there. Anyways, I'm gonna end it right here. Thank you guys for watching. Y'all have a good nice day. Peace out.
Even if you are not ready for the day, it cannot always be night.